Hi, this is Andrew with RPS Solar Pumps, and today I wanted to talk to you about pressure switches. These are very useful devices for integrating into your RPS solar pumps. They have very specific uses, and we're going to talk about how we plumb them in and use them in lieu of our standard liquid level switch. So what we have here are three different pieces of equipment that would be integrated into a system that would require a reverse action pressure switch. The first one is your general off-grid well tank system. You can see the pressure switch is installed in place. It has some critical components such as the pressure gauge, the bladder, and a bleed off valve and a high pressure safety valve. The second use we have is an off-grid irrigation. This is just a standard DC timer that opens and closes a valve, and that will cause the pressure to spike and shut the system off. And then we have our final component, which is for remote sensing of tank levels remotely from the actual installation of the well. So what we have here is a livestock watering trough, and you can see right now we're currently filling the tank, and as we fill the tank, the ball float pushes against the valve and starts to close off the flow of water. On the other side at the beginning, down near the bottom of the well, we have our check valve, which only prevents water to flow in the forward direction. And as this happens, the pressure starts to spike and the contact closes on the pressure switch, and at the same time you'll also see the tank full status light up and the pump will begin to slow down and turn off. Okay, so we have the reverse situation here where your cows are slowly drinking down the water, the trough is emptying and opening the valve. This will release the pressure in the line and cause the contacts to open in the pressure switch. This will tell the controller that the tank is no longer full, the pump status begins to illuminate, and water begins to flow through the system. I want to talk now about the functions and features of a pressure switch and how it integrates into our RPS solar system. What you have here is a pressure switch with the all-weather cover. We'll take this off. You can see on the front there is a lever that allows you to select the different mode that the pressure switch will operate in. There's some spring-loaded adjustment bolts right here, and we'll get to those later. And then on the bottom, this is the pressure port that sends the water signal to a diaphragm down below that translates that into whether or not the switch will remain open or closed. So with most of our kits, they come with a reverse action pressure switch. And what this will say, tell the system, is that in the normally open state, which is the state that there is no pressure, the switch will be open. And this will tell the system that the system needs to begin pumping to generate pressure, and then when pressure is achieved, the switch closes. This is runs opposite to what normal pressure switches do. It's the reverse logic. Okay, so here we have the reverse action pressure switch with the cover removed. You can see there's contacts on both sides. We'll only be using one for the installation. Down below you can see the adjustment screws. This is the cutoff screw and this is the differential adjustment screw. And then next to that is the lever, which is the mode selector. So I can simply change it and top the tank off, or tell the system that the tank is topped off simply by turning the lever up. And then we can remove it and turn it back to auto mode by opening the lever once again. So to wire in your reverse action pressure switch, you can use the wiring from your typical liquid level switch. The wire comes with a bundle of two wires, and really all you need to do is generate continuity across the switch to tell the system that we no longer need system pressure and it shuts the pump off. Okay, so to wire in your reverse action pressure switch, all you need to do is make a connection between this screw right here and this screw right here. And what that'll do is when the system loses pressure, the contacts will open. You'll lose continuity between these two terminals right here. That information is relayed back to the controller and it tells the system that it's time to energize the pump
and generate pressure. So here we've set up a small test system right here to demonstrate how we can adjust the reverse action pressure switch. We're not going to go over how to adjust the differential switch on the back. What you can see right here is the larger cutoff switch here, and that's what we're going to adjust. So to increase pressure, the cutoff pressure, we want to turn the bolt clockwise, okay? And so right now, first we'll just see what our factory set point is and confirm whether or not it's 50 PSI. We'll go ahead and start closing this gate valve. And this gate valve is a stand-in for many of the pieces of equipment that you see right here. Okay, so we're going to go ahead and build pressure. We're up near 30 PSI already, and we're slowly closing, and we hit 50 PSI, and our switch is closed. This isn't currently wired into the system, so that's why you're not seeing the system shut off. So we're going to go ahead and show it, as we back off on the pressure, how the system will open the switch again. Okay, so we're going to close it, and as we turn it, we can see the pressure dropping down. We're hitting 30 PSI, and just about 30 PSI, the switch comes back on. All right, so if we want to increase the pressure, we want to turn that bolt clockwise. And so we'll put our little bolt on here, and we'll start turning it down. We'll do, how about two full turns? And see where that gets us. Okay, and now our switch is in the normally open position. We're gonna go ahead and start building pressure, and we'll do that by closing the gate valve once again. So I'll move my hand out of the way too. And as we build pressure, what's our new pressure? So it looks like with just two turns, we've managed to increase our pressure, our cutoff pressure, by about 5 PSI. So once again, this is Andrew with RPS Solar Pumps. If you have any questions about how to integrate one of these into your RPS solar system, or just have any general questions, why don't you give us a call, 888-637-4493.